Dear students, welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. Today we are going to discuss about the consequences of air pollution, as we already discussed what is air pollution and what are the causes or source of air pollution. So today we will try to describe you or discuss you in detail what are the effects or consequences of different pollutants which have been releasing by anthropogenic activities or by releasing by natural means. So we will try to discuss the issues or the effects caused by the air pollution. There are so many effects caused by the air pollution, and the effects are on different sectors. We can see effects of air pollution on human being, effects on human being, the effects may be on plants and beneficial microorganisms or organisms. It may be, the effects may be on crops, which results the productivity of crop in turn economy. We can have the effects of air pollution on aquatic ecosystem. We can also have the effects on material and property, and we may have effects of air pollution on climate, we say global warming or global warming. So these are the effects which are caused by air pollution or the pollutants of air after being released into our atmosphere. So we'll try to discuss all these effects one by one. So what are the effects of air pollution on human being? If we see the effects of air pollution on human being, so many effects have been recognized or determined by the presence of air pollution or air pollutants in the air, and it affects or deteriorates the health status of human being. And the pollution of air especially affects on two age groups, especially the elders and the younger ones. And out of the elder ones also, the most effect have been observed in patients which are already suffering from disease like asthma, bronchitis and other respiratory related diseases. So we will try to discuss effects one by one. What are the effects of different pollutants on the health status of human being? So first we would like to discuss you about the effect of carbon monoxide on human health or human health status. As we all know, carbon monoxide is the product of incomplete combustion of the fossil fuels, either being released from the industries, factories, automobiles or from domestic sources. And the characteristics of carbon monoxide is that it has got the affinity to combine with hemoglobin. As all we know, it carries oxygen to different parts of the tissues. Hemoglobin is having the characteristics of carrying oxygen to different parts of the tissues, and the carbon monoxide is having a characteristics of an affinity or we can say a binding property with hemoglobin 210 times more than that of oxygen. It means in any particular situation, if both oxygen and carbon monoxide is present, then carbon monoxide is having 210 times more affinity with hemoglobin, more combining capability with hemoglobin as compared to the presence of oxygen. Means the binding capability of carbon monoxide with hemoglobin is more, which results the formation of carboxyhemoglobin. Means carbon monoxide gets attached with the hemoglobin, which results the reduce of oxygen carrying capacity through hemoglobin in a human being. And results may affect like headache, nausea, it may result dizziness, and if the carbon monoxide is present in very high amount, it proves lethal. Lethal means it can cause death of the human being because no oxygen is being supplied, because the carbon monoxide gets attached with the hemoglobin and reduces the oxygen carrying capacity, which results the effects like headache, nausea, dizziness, and finally it may result death of the individual, and the effect is being more observed in elderly and children's. So what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to avoid in such situations which is having more amount of carbon monoxide in a particular situation. Say for example, in winters we are using coal, we are using wood, we are using other fossil fuels for heating purpose, then we must ensure that the proper ventilation is there, so that the carbon monoxide, if formed there, if generates a carbon monoxide is there, then the carbon monoxide gets diluted or it gets released through the cross ventilation. This was the effect of carbon monoxide. Then we will discuss about the effects of nitrogen oxide. What are the effects of nitrogen oxide? No doubt, nitrogen is also a product of pollutant released from industries, from factories, from automobiles, from domestic sources, and from thermal power plants, and from forest fires, and so many other sources are there by release of nitrogen oxide. And nitrogen oxide affects the human health status on different ways. For example, it produces nitrous and nitric oxide as it gets entered into the human being, and it damages the tissues of lungs. Means the intrusion of NO2, oxides of nitrogen, enters human being, and formation of nitrous and nitric oxides damage the tissue of human lungs. As a result, the human being or the individual or the patient gets problem in proper breathing. Hence, he or she acquires a disease related to the respiration. Similarly, if a person is continuously gets exposed to the oxides of nitrogen, it may cause bronchitis among human beings. Bronchitis if continuous exposure of NO2 may result bronchitis among the human being besides acute respiratory diseases. Similarly, the presence of NO2 forms nitrosoamines, which is very toxic in nature and are carcinogenic in nature. Carcinogen means it can cause cancer among human beings, and hence the presence of NO2 and exposure to the NO2 to any particular human being results acute respiratory disease. If the formation of nitrosoamines is there, then it is toxic and results carcinogenic, or it proves cancer causing agent. Similarly, it may cause this dermatitis. It may result eczema. It may result other respiratory inflammation like oedema. So these are some of the effects caused by NO2. Means in an advanced stage, the presence of NO2 may result hemorrhage. For example, the presence of NO2 may cause hemorrhage. It may also cause, as already discussed, cancer. It may also cause rashes. It may also result inflammation of respiratory system, and it may also cause damage to the entire respiratory system before pneumonia. And these are the diseases which are related to the presence of only nitrogen dioxide or the oxides of nitrogen. If we never control or check the presence of NO2, then we may get these diseases, and with the passage of time, our respiratory system will get efficiency of our respiratory system will get reduced, and with the passage of time we may acquire many diseases like bronchitis, fibrosa, and so many other respiratory diseases. That's why what we are supposed to do, if we saw the presence of nitrogen dioxide in any particular situation, be it in offices, be it in home or industries, what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to take precautions to protect ourselves from the damage may cause to our respiratory system. Then it may also have effects on the plants. Deleterious effects or damaging effect is also caused by NO2 to plants, and the effects are maybe chlorosis. It may cause necrosis. It may cause epinasty. And so many other related diseases. So the exposure of plants or the crops, we say, to the NO2 or nitrogen oxide results chlorosis. Chlorosis means reduction in chlorophyll. As we all know, Chlorophyll is the main constituent among the plants which is responsible for the formation of crops or food in the plants, and damage of chlorophyll content among the human being results the decrease of productivity among the crops. Then epinasty is already discussed. Necrosis is here. Necrosis simply means dead areas on leaves. Dead areas on leaves where actually the production takes place. Then epinasty, downward curling of leaves and may get fall down within a passage of time. And abscission is also there. Abscission means dropping of leaves. Dropping of leaves. Simply, the presence of NO2 or a nitrogen oxide in a particular situation where the plants are flourishing or plants are growing, chlorosis may occur. Chlorosis simply means reduction of chlorophyll content among the plants, among the leaf of the plants, which results the decrease in productivity of the crops. And necrosis causes the death of the death support on the plant leaves. And similarly, the epinasty, downward curling of the leaves, and productivity is also get reduced. And finally, abscission means dropping of leaves. These are some of the causes of NO2 either on plants or on human beings. Then in the next very lecture, we will try to discuss about the effects of NO2 or NOx on the materials and the property. Till then, stay home, stay safe, best of luck.